You're watching Marketplace on News Channel 20.
Good Wednesday morning, everyone. Welcome to Marketplace. I'm meteorologist Bryan Schuerman filling in for Natalie today. Thanks for joining us. We've got a lot to get to this morning, including the latest on the coronavirus vaccine that was announced earlier this week, and also some welcome changes coming back if you're going to be hitting the friendly skies as we head into the holidays. But first, let's get to the latest on the 2020 presidential election this morning.
And I realize a lot of people are happy about this election, and a lot of people are not happy about this election. One thing I can't comprehend is how hungry people are to consume lies and to consume information that is not true.
President Trump continues to refuse concede defeat in the presidential election, blocking the transition to a Biden administration as his campaign challenges the ballot counts with no evidence of widespread fraud this morning. At the same time, President-elect Joe Biden forges ahead. ABC's Mary Bruce has the latest.
This morning, as President Trump continues to defy the outcome of the election, unwilling to admit defeat, President-elect Joe Biden is trying to reassure Americans that Trump won't derail his transition.
We don't see anything as slowing us down, quite frankly.
He's forging ahead, even though the president still insists we will win. Trump has been holed up in the White House, filing long-shot legal challenges, but he has yet to provide any evidence of widespread fraud. His administration refusing to take key steps to begin the transfer of power. The nation's top diplomat, Secretary of State Mike Pompeo, perpetuating the false narrative that Trump could still win.
Is the State Department currently preparing to engage with the Biden transition team? And if not, at what point does a delay hamper a smooth transition or pose a risk to national security?
There will be a smooth transition to a second Trump administration.
While on the Hill Tuesday, Vice President Mike Pence, also at odds with reality, refusing to comment or come to terms with the election results.
Mr. Vice President, is it time to concede? Is there really any evidence of fraud?
We asked the president-elect how he's planning to move forward with the transition.
How will you move ahead if the president continues to refuse to concede?
We're going
to
do exactly what we'd be doing if he had conceded and said we've won, which we have. And so there's nothing really changing.
But not ruling out legal action?
No, I don't see a need for legal action, quite frankly. So far, there is no evidence of any of the assertions made by the president or Secretary of State Pompeo. Secretary of State Pompeo.
And pressed on his message to Americans worried about Trump's refusal to concede.
I just think it's an embarrassment, quite frankly. The only thing that, how can I say this tactfully? I think it will not help the president's legacy.
The news of the vaccine should not get people to say that we don't need to continue to do the public health measures, because I look at the vaccine is that help is coming and it's coming soon.
And other headlines this morning, new hope today in the fight against the COVID-19 pandemic, the next steps for the vaccine being released. Pfizer laying out how it plans to distribute hundreds of millions of doses if approved. ABC's Steve Osunami has more.
As the clinical trials this morning for the various coronavirus vaccines are wrapping up, the drug maker out the gate first says it will work with local governments to move the drug across the U.S. Drug maker Pfizer says that seniors who are more at risk and first responders like doctors and nurses will get the drug before anyone else. California's Vandenberg Air Force Base will be one of the first places to get shipments of the vaccine. Hospitals, clinics, and pharmacies will follow. Moving the doses is a huge challenge. Patients need two doses and they have to be stored in freezers that keep them around 94 degrees below zero. Pfizer is planning to use specially designed temperature-controlled thermal shipping with dry ice and GPS sensors that track the location and temperature of the packages. They're using FedEx and UPS, both air and ground service, to get the vaccine shipped anywhere in the country within 2 days. Dr. Anthony Fauci says that most Americans will not get their doses of the vaccine until early next year.
We're talking probably by April, the end of April, I would think. Again, these are just guesstimates.
Right.
And doctors say that when you do get the shots, don't be surprised to feel your body respond, saying some people feel sore arms after the injection and aches and pains. The Army General in charge of vaccine distribution says he's concerned that Americans won't take the vaccine.
If we get vaccines to the American people and they don't take them, shame on us. Hey, I was already sick. I don't need it. Shame on us. And it does keep me up at night.
An investigation by ProPublica found that some parts of the country are going to have an easier time moving and storing this vaccine in the necessary cold. They found that cities and urban areas will have an easier time doing this than rural parts of the country. Steve Osunzami, ABC News, Atlanta.
And still to come on Marketplace, new research today that when it comes to fighting the coronavirus, being fit can make a difference. We'll have the details you need to know coming up. Plus, some sense of normalcy is coming back to one of the major airlines as we head straight into the holiday season. Details on what's coming back to the friendly skies when we come back. Stay with us.